press the bell icon on our YouTube app and never miss another video from Spotboy.
What happens when Navi Mumbai, Bandra and Thane come together? Right? Magic happens, and that's what happened in 1996 when this trio got together.
You got it wrong. I don't live in Thane anymore.
No,
you
used to. 1996,
you used to. So, give us a sense of how it was when the three of you decided, KR, saath mein kaam karte hai. Do you remember that day?
Yeah, I remember the day. It's like spending half hours in traffic. that's the downside of living.
I still do that.
So what was that moment like? Do you remember ridiculous. That day, the specific conversation that happened? KR, karte na saath mein kaam.
He knows.
Nothing. I made a call to these guys after that. No mobile phones hadn't come yet. I finished this meeting with Mukul Anand, and I went home and I called up these guys and said that there's this offer to do a film. Would you like to do it? Just together for fun. Not we hadn't planned anything, and they said, yeah, why not, man? And okay. That is it.
So it's a very interesting concoction that has created magic over the years. Or us din ye log razi hue ek saath kaam karne ke liye, and here we are 22 years later. They are all set to give us four more magical tracks. Four tracks, is it, in Razi?
Four, yes.
It's a different kind of film. It's not your regular rom-com, etc. kind of film. It's a film that's set in an era 50 years ago. So what is the kind of prep that goes into creating music for such a film?
Story, from the story itself, because the story automatically suggests a certain thing. You cannot add something that will not sit comfortably in that space, if you want to call it that.
And the thing is that Meghna never said to make the music period specific. I mean, 70s then would get into something else.
Sure.
The point is that we tried, experiments and stuff, but the thing is we kept it basically, keep the music earthy, like very world. And because it's from that part of India, which is, like Kashmir and then across the border, the north, Pakistan and all those places. So we use a lot of the instruments of that area, like there is rabab, there is, a little bit of santur here and there. And there's the whole Afghani kind of sound also in it. So basically we kept that. It's a very earthy sounding album. There's not much electronics and stuff. And that was it. That was a brief, that she wanted it earthy and she wanted it very emotional.
How did the film come about? Was it Gulzar Sahab who called, or was it Meghna who said, karte hai film, this is the story? What was that briefing like?
A few months before we started working on Meghna, actually a year before, we started working on Meghna's script. Meghna had called one day and she said, after a long time, I have put on a CD into my CD player and I have spent an entire evening listening to a CD from the beginning to the end. And I don't know which is the last album I've done that in Hindi film music.
Okay.
And that was Mirziya.
Wow.
She said, I'm so proud of you all and, it's such a wonderful piece of music you all have created. And so at that time, I told her that, we would be more than happy to work with you. Anytime you make anything, we are with you. Because we know that, I have seen Talwar and... we know the passion in a director when you watch a film like that, So we said that we'll work with you anytime you make anything, just let us know. And that time she was in the process of writing Razi. She said, I'm writing something. I'm definitely going to. The day she finished her script, the day she got a bound thing, I think we are
the first people
whom she approached. Obviously, Gulzaza was. He's there, part of the team, but she approached us first and she said, my script is ready, would you like to hear it?
Wow.
And then we went and we heard the script and we were blown, man, I'm telling you.
So clearly the film does have the Gulzar impact as well.
Of course.
Now, we just saw him outside, he has this magical aura about him. So give us a sense of what those conversations are with him. Does he impart Urdu lessons? Does he share couplets or stories from his earlier days? How is it like? I'm sure there must be some various stories that you heard from him and conversations with him.
He can be very minimalistic in a lot of times. And sometimes, it's just that one thing that he'll say over lunch or whenever, and on a break. And he says, oh my God, it's all condensed.
Like what?
Many things are,
Actually,
the context
thing is,
I'm
talking
about
the Hindi and the Urdu. He always, when he reads out the words, he always stops to explain the words in English.
Wow.
Means to this thing. Delhi's means the threshold of a door, that's called Delhi's. That kind of stuff. So, it's very, he's always very, very accommodating. Because what a level of Hindi, and we too don't speak Hindi also. he's just very, and besides all that, he's just very, He's a very well-read man.
Yeah. Is it intimidating when you met him for the first time? Like, wow, never, the legend.
I remember the first time I got a call from him after listening to the melody of Rockford. Rockford, we had composed and we had put it down on a cassette. That time there were cassettes. That was, God knows, about 15 or 20 years back or something. Then I just sung the melody and quickly put it onto a cassette because Nagesh Kuknor wanted to send the cassette to Gulzar Sahab. And then I took a flight and I went away somewhere for about 15, 20 days. And then I had almost like forgotten about it that we have sent this thing. And one day, suddenly, get a call and then he says that this is Gulzar here.
Wow.
Means I almost like dropped the phone. And then I said, oh God. Then I remembered, oh God, I've given him this melody. So I said, what's he going to react? And I've never ever spoken to him ever. Then he said, what a beautiful melody it is, and this and that. He gave a lot of blessings and love over the phone only. Wow, I said, my God. Then our journey started there, man.
And wow is a word that the whole country is using for Ae Watan. It's such a powerful track. Now, every song has a story behind it. So what's the story behind Ae Watan's creation?
Ae Watan, see the things in the film, you see Alia singing this, teaching the school kids this song. And
that's sung by Sunidhi.
That's therefore right. the female version of the song. And then Arijit's song is separate, which comes in. The thing is that she wanted a patriotic song, you know, which really is the basic essence of the film is that. It's all about patriotism. The film is about patriotism. It's about unsung heroes, you know, about people behind the borders and all who don't get Paramveer Chakras and, you know, they're just people who we don't know and what they've been through and the lives that they live and stuff like that. So basically, this was the song which would be the binding song of the film. You know, the essence, spirit of the film would be in the song. And the thing is that the way Gulzar Sahab put forward, I mean, she didn't want words like Janda Ucha Rahe Hamara, you know, that kind of stuff which has been done
sure.
to death in different things, you know, not only in corporate, you know, like even in corporate songs and stuff. But basically, she wanted a song which would be earthy, would be full of heart, and yet bringing the message across, you know, very strong. And so in really simple, I mean, the way he wrote the words, Shankar looked at the words and started composing it as he was like reading the words literally.
Wow. It's,
and like Gulzar said, you all were like a pilot, you know, I was following you writing the Andhra. That kind of thing, that is as simple as that, like simple composition. And in that simplicity, you can see there's such a long message. And the thing is that simplest songs are the toughest to compose.
And it's also the silence of saying something in your heart. You don't have to say it loud. That's
what
obvious,
do you feel
you
for
know?
Your country, for
you
example?
Know, everything that's kept in here and then you voice it from that perspective.
It's your personal love for your country.
That's very different.
That's it.
You know, it reminds me of a poem, an old English poem called The Dying Soldier.
Okay.
Who's an English soldier who's killed somewhere in Europe or something. And he's saying that where I die, that place will forever be England.
Wow.
As I keep England in my heart. The same way the song has got that same kind of thing. That where I am in the world. You know, what's the word?
Main jahan rahun, jahan mein.
Yeah, jahan mein.
Ah.
So whichever part of the world is, my vatan stays with me. The spirit of my country stays in my heart.
Yaad rahe tu. It's amazing.
And you chose Arijit for it, who is known for mostly romantic tracks. So why Arijit for this track?
Arijit is a phenomenal artist. He's a phenomenal artist.
Absolutely.
And if you can sing a romantic song well, you can sing a patriotic song even well. Because what is the basic common factor? Soul. You have to have soul in your voice, you know.
Now, lots of stories do the rounds about Arijit. People say, I don't know how far true this is, but they say he's a bit of a recluse. It's difficult to get access to him. How is he to deal with him?
He is a pure artist without any BS attached to him.
Yeah,
he's so down to earth. And, you know,
after a long time, our industry has got an artist who's got tremendous depth, tremendous knowledge. And tremendous, vocabulary of music. So he can sing Binte Dil from Padmavat. He can sing Mast Magan from Two States. He can sing Channa Mereya. And he can sing Ae Watan. So he's the most versatile artist.
Is he a misunderstood guy? He's not out there like a lot of his contemporaries. Is he misunderstood?
He doesn't need to be.
Look at him. I mean, his talent is phenomenal. The way he sings is fantastic.
It's nice to have a little bit of mystery around you always.
Sure.
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah, the thing is, he's not into the hardcore media and into the limelight.
He's going to be here for many, many years, a long time.
To prove himself.
He does work the way he does work.
Sure. Right. Now.
And in terms of acting, Alia Bhatt is that kind of actor too.
Correct.
She'll be around when she's 80 years old acting.
True.
You know what I mean?
She's a phenomenal artist.
Right. There is another powerhouse of our industry. Now, people say that logo ke family doctors, hote hain, family tax advisors, hote hain, consultants. Hote hain. Aap log Javed saab ki family ke? आप फैमिली म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर्स हैं उनके, सो व्हाट इज दिस रिलेशनशिप, मैजिकल रिलेशनशिप विद एक्सएल, कि जावेद साहब फिल्म बना रहे हैं, फरहान अख्तर फिल्म बना रहे हैं, चलो एसएल.
आई थिंक इट्स अ इट्स टू फोल्ड. वन इज अ रिलेशनशिप यू बिल्ड विद समबडी एंड देयर इज अ सर्टेन ट्रस्ट फैक्टर दैट दे कैन ट्रस्ट यू टू डिलीवर यू नो व्हाट दे आर लुकिंग फॉर, यू नो दैट्स इट्स प्रीटी मच इट आई थिंक.
ओके,
ट्रेमेंडस लव एंड रिस्पेक्ट फॉर ईच अदर.
Javed Saab is one of the funniest people when he is in his own, when I've seen him in interviews. He's a bit of a riot when he's...
He's an amazing, amazing, amazing person. I mean, he's one of those writers, jab wo likhte hain, people remember the whole mukhda, the whole antra. When we sing, for example, Kal Ho Na Ho, or Rock On, or Dil Dhadakne Do, Galla Godiya, people remember, Senorita. Look at the string of hits we've got with him. You know,
it's been a terrific part.
Huge. And people remember the entire song. Dekhi, first two lines you can remember of a song. Or the mukhda maximum you can remember. Correct. You can't remember first antara, second antara. Dil Chahta Hai, they remember the entire song.
Correct.
That is the beauty of Javed Saab.
So Dil Chahta Hai, I believe Sankar Ehsaan Loy, Javed Saab and Farhan Akhtar were locked in a house or a cottage for 3.5 days. Creating six songs.
The idea was to go for 10 days.
And you finished it in 3.5 days.
We finished in 3 days, and out of which half a day, maybe one full day was spent laughing.
Javed Ji means only laughing.
So tell us about the creation of Dil Chahta Hai, which is really your takeoff album, wasn't it?
We were literally sitting on the swing outside, you know, and composing music. And Shankar Rama came back, he's gone to brush his teeth. And he came back because we had this little thing, you know. This little thing.
Yeah.
We don't know what we were going to use. In fact, it was originally for Jaane Kyu, the Jaane Kyu thing.
It was a song that was going around this bass line.
Yeah, this bass line. This bass line was going around and we didn't know what we were going to use. So he's suddenly having a brushing his teeth and he comes out with a towel around his neck. Dil Chahta Hai. That's it, you know. And the thing is, as we were going up to Khandala, we were driving up, we were hearing an album called the Afro-Celt sound system, which was very popular at that time. So a lot of Celtic music with things. So Shankar saying, let's write a Celtic song. So okay, we get to Khandala and see them. He just sat on the keyboard and that it was just like, and then the song I think we composed after that was Tanhai.
Yeah. I had the bass line going. It was
fantastic. And then one afternoon we just ate lunch and then we had all intentions to compose. All we did was sleep. The full afternoon we were all out.
It was great food.
Now talking of lunch and food, is there like a prep khana routine? Shankar Madhavan cooks and says,
"Chalo." It's a very important topic
in this group.
Yeah, I mean, because
like even on this film, on Razi, oh man, we had some great food.
Oh my God, there's food
but
coming.
Is there a ritual?
I mean, Meghna's husband, Govind. He's an incredible cook.
But sir, so are you. So is there a routine that, chalo yaar, aaj main khana banata hu, fir kaam shuru karenge?
Nahi, mujhe bahut kam aisa time milta hai ki main khana bana ke yahan par laun, because I live far away and by the time I leave and come. Lekin there are people like when we work with Shad, there is food coming from his house. When we work with Meghna, food coming from Rakhi ji's house, from her house. Her husband makes the most amazing food. Rakhi ji sends fish for us. Guldar sahab, all of us, we sit and we eat. When we are working with Rakesh Mehra, that's another story. Topic is only food. So, invariably, Shad, we keep meeting. Shad's house is unbelievable. So, invariably, we end up, you know.
So, it's Gana, Bajana and Khana.
Khana is
number one.
And then the Khana.
Actually, they're very strongly related.
Yeah, try listening to music when you're very hungry.
It's very, 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 very strong relation to the process.
Aur aana chahiye suron mein, as they say. The one thing that troubles the world these days is technology, specifically WhatsApp. So do you guys have a WhatsApp group? And
of course.
I believe there's one person among the three of you who never responds.
Loyal.
I got no time for it, man.
Forget about WhatsApp. Loyal will not respond even if you call him. Half the time, you won't even. Sometimes you have to wonder, where is this guy? You know, in the 2 days.
If I'm studying something, that's so important to me.
We have to call up his children, please go to the house and check.
And you wouldn't agree to have a GPS chip implanted on you, saying, that's how, at least maybe that's how we can track.
Has he been abducted? You know, something like that. We have to find all these things. There's a lot of stories to the way some of our songs have been created, especially one, which is actually a classic story, which I have to say, this is everyone's going to be watching. It was from Bhag Milka Bhagals. A song called Mera Yaar?
Mera Yaar Mila De.
Mera
Yaar Mila De.
Yeah, that one. Mera Yaar. And we were...
Yeah, but the rub varga. Thank you for
saying the correct lyrics. And we were sitting outside in outside the studio, you know, just after lunch. And
we had finished Orangrez.
And at that time, everybody wanted to use all the Pakistani singers, you know, I mean, like, you know, Arif Lohar, you know, all the guys out there. They're all fantastic singers. Yeah. And Shankar is saying, let's just use one of our singers from here. Instead of calling somebody from there who will sing that, na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. So I said, let's use that as a melody. Let's use that as a melody. And we went into the studio and put the melody.
Wow.
That is very crazy, man, the way that whole song happened.
I was trying to create a joke, actually.
A joke.
Why should we write a song like this? So that's a great melody. Let's put it on. The song is made.
Mazak, mazak, magic create.
Victim of his watch.
Really, really, it was fantastic. And eventually, a Pakistani singer did sing it.
Of course, and what a phenomenal
job. What a fantastic singer.
You guys are approaching the half century mark. I believe Razi is the 47th or the 48th film, if I've got the number right.
Probably.
We've gone past 60.
No,
55.
No, no, I think it's about the 50th, I think.
Around the 50th mark.
Yeah, I think we've done more than 60.
I don't know, we can check our list online.
But 22-year long journey, and this is for all three of you. What has been the greatest high point? It could be a conversation, it could be a song, it could be an award, it could be anything.
It's just too many moments. It's just like, it's really about moments, you know. Maybe, for example, we're talking about food. Food could be one important moment. I'm not talking about the compositional part of it. That's another thing in itself. And there are times when we're in the room and, you know, everyone kind of feels this thing. I think this is a good song. It feels
that
right.
That rush that you get.
It's a certain energy in the room. And it's a very silent thing. Everyone kind of knows it, acknowledges. We never talk about it at that point. We come back after, you notice, we always come back after many days and we say, there's something nice about this. So that's a personal thing with the three of us. So.
You know, this moment is also very special for us. I'll tell you why. Imagine you're standing in the middle of a road and you're looking back and you see these various, you know, milestones that are put. So when you look back now, you're seeing a Mirziya, you're seeing a Dil Dhadakne Do, you're seeing a Zindagi Na Milege Dobara, then you're seeing a Rock On, you're seeing a Banti Aur Babli, you're seeing Jhoom Barabar Jhoom, you're seeing Tare Zameen Par, you're seeing Rock On, I mean, you're seeing Kal Ho Na Ho. Wow. You're seeing the number of milestones. Yeah, then you realize that, hey man, it's not been a bad body of work. See, there are many people who have created this aura that, you know, they're very big artists. But if you go and analyze their body of work, you'll realize, arey, itna kuch nahi hai, yaar, theek hai, body of work. I won't mention names. Sure. I'm not taking musically, I'm telling maybe actors.
Sure.
You look at a great actor and say, what is his body of work? What is it that he has done which his kids can be proud of? But when we look at our body of work, we feel that we have done some, I think, solid stuff.
Path-breaking
work. So that's why it's a happy moment.
And I believe the number three has played a huge role. I believe you guys are very superstitious about it. So... three good things about each other, or three bad things about us. Three things that you absolutely love and absolutely hate about each other. We can go to each one of you one by one.
But how can we say three? It means I have to say six things.
Well, three in all.
Common.
Sorry. Yeah.
Three things that I love about these guys are their musicality, obviously. Different viewpoint of looking at, I mean, different take on every song. And how a simple melody changes when these two guys come into the picture.
Wow.
And third thing is the humor. I mean, it's crazy, man. It's almost tending towards gossip. So that humor, you know, that kind of humor.
Yeah, yeah. There are other words that you could use for it.
I got it.
Yeah. And three bad things. Why should I talk negativity? But we don't
three
like
fun
negativity.
Things. Three fun things. Three fun quirks, things. Idiosyncrasies.
Paranoia like, to the extent of, I mean, some of you laugh.
Like what?
Talking about me.
About everything.
There's another thing. I believe he cannot stop talking about Nazis and the World War. Is that true?
That's absolutely true. You've done UFOs. A good research.
And UFOs as well.
So what dream, is our obsession about
this? His bucket list is to be abducted.
I want to be abducted by aliens. I really want to be abducted.
And what?
Go with them.
I feel sorry for the aliens.
But yeah. He's always smiling. They'll say, hasta hua noorani chehra or whatever.
There's so many things, man. Each day an experience is an experience. I'm telling you, like you say about a high point. There's little high points that happen every day. You know, sometimes you just crack a joke or... about something, about somebody.
About and, somebody.
About somebody. Something. Not something. I mean, somebody normally. And then it's just that love, you can't work anymore. You know?
Okay, so how well do you know each other? There's a spice brand that he created a jingle for years ago. Do you remember the brand or the jingle?
Sona Spice.
Oh, you do. Oh, do you remember the jingle?
Yeah, of course, man. You're free to do. Let's do keys wrong. You're free to do the things you really want to do because you know how. That's good.
Beautiful. One about him, I believe he acted in a Marathi film. Do you remember the name of the film?
Yeah, Katyayar. Kaljat Ghusli. Yeah, that's right.
Got
he's
the
also acted in a TV serial long ago for Mukul Anand.
Ex Se Badkar Ek in 1996.
Right.
What was the school that he taught at? You taught music at a school, I believe.
Delhi School of Music.
Fantastic. Yeah, kya partnership hai. They know everything.
MSM.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, not so a couple
of... Oh, sure, not Delhi MSM. School. So I was wrong.
What school is it?
Mount St. Mary's, MSM.
So do you miss those... teaching days?
Beautiful days. I mean, lovely to interact with the kids.
He's a very good teacher, but even now.
I love to teach.
And one of his students was Shah Rukh Khan, by the way.
Not student, but I was writing music for plays when I was in Delhi. And Shah Rukh was, you know, at that point.
4G is on it, no?
I did 4G at that point. Shah Rukh's first
TV series.
Okay, something about the three of you, or individually, or together, that the world doesn't know. Because I took about 6 to 8 hours of research to prep for this interview. There is some stuff available, but is there something that you would like the world to know that they don't know?
Yeah, like a lot of information on me on Wikipedia is totally wrong. And I purposely keep it that way. I never
go to Wikipedia.
No. It's great because, you know, a lot of times, you know, people are doing a thing for the show and, you know, they'll do the thing from there and they'll
go on looking stage. At him, what do you think would be his favorite cuisine? Chalo.
Something cheesy, buttery.
His favorite cuisine is rasam.
Yeah, rasam and
vada sambar, dosa.
Is that because he spent 2 decades with you?
No. It's got nothing to do with me, boss. Inside him is a palakada air, I think. So. Yeah.
And about you?
What?
Something the world doesn't know?
About me?
He's a very good artist. His caricatures.
I read about that. Okay, what happens?
He's passionate about. He never talks about music. Is if we're on a flight together and like I'm picking his brains about something. Like most of the time, yeah, he'll indulge you a little bit in it. But it's like if you're talking about food, like, oh, now let's talk.
So you can have your own food show someday. Is that something?
You should.
Planning one.
Online, on digital.
Fantastic. Not online, maybe all mediums.
So are they the guinea pigs? I'm making you eat.
Yeah, 100%. They'll be the guests on one of the episodes for sure.
Wow. And your obsession with trumpets, is that true?
I love musical instruments, and for me it's a lot.
Neighbor.
A lot of times,
if you
play a little bit, it helps you in your writing because I'll tell you what happens with this generation because we're all keyboard players.
Right.
We don't understand the concept of breathing. Okay. So you have to know. I mean, yes, you can. If you study it, fine. But it gives you a little insight about a lot of things. You know, like if you play a little bit of guitar, I mean, you can't play. A piano voicing on a guitar is going to sound wrong. So
right.
If you want a certain realism to it, you have to start. A little bit, just basics.
So 2 decades of iconic work. You've seen the highs and you've seen other challenging phases as well, which we won't go into. But what is it that will make you say no to a film or yes to a film? What is that clincher or a deal breaker?
Sometimes I think it's just instinctively. Yeah. Sometimes we've had, I mean, of course, there's some films that we've been approached where we know that this is going to be one of the secret films.
Oh.
Which has been we've actually indulged the producer to hear everything about the film.
So we can have,
so we have something to laugh about. But basically, sometimes you just know that it's not right. You know it's not going to work from a script level. You know, and invariably, I think there's somebody like a guiding force that guides us in doing the right work. You know,
and it's got nothing to do with the budget of the film. Huh?
Nothing to do with the budget. There's people are willing to pay money, but sometimes it just doesn't work out.
Sometimes Sometimes the films are so small, but we just love the person who comes to meet you. Or even the script. We love it so much, we say, yes, we'll do it.
So money is never a factor?
Never.
Has Javed Saab ever asked for a discount saying, yaar, aap toh ghar ke ho, thoda kam le lo. Is that ever happens?
He doesn't need to ask.
Is it true that you guys have also created a song over WhatsApp? Was it Orangrez?
That's modern composing. Yeah. I mean, completely between two roads, actually. He's stuck on one road in traffic, I'm stuck on a parallel road in traffic, and I'm supposed to come down that road, eventually take a U-turn and get onto his road only. But the thing is, we were stuck and we had this ideas were just flowing for a song, you know. So I'd sing the ta-ra-na-na-na-na, ta-ra-na-na-na-na, and I'll send it to him. And he'd sing ta-ra-ra-ra, dee-da-dee-da, da-ra-ra-ra, and send it back. Oh man, we've got a song. Next time he came and put it together with his... And that's it. The whole song happened just like around.
This is over WhatsApp.
Yeah. Over WhatsApp.
I'm sure you didn't respond.
No, he was not part of it.
I was not part of it.
Okay.
Because we'd send it to him, he wouldn't even know which song we're talking about, which film we're talking about, which producer we're talking about.
And then tell them about after this song, we finished recording this song, then what happened? Remember we were sitting out.
Huh?
And oh, then the other song.
Oh, yes. Oh, there's another song, man. We should that. Mera yaar, na na na. What's that song? What's the song is called? What's it called?
Mera yaar hai rab varga.
That song. And we were saying that we had to call some particular kind of singer and do this particular song. Sadly,
rustic
Sufi. Rustic and Sufi. So he's saying, why do we have to always do song that with this rustic? Because when somebody's going to sing, ta-na-na-na-na-na-na. So I said, boss, let's use that as the melody. Let's use that as the melody. We went into the studio and straight put the idea down.
Mazak, mazak, magic ho raha
hai. Yeah.
I was trying to make a joke. I said, na 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 na. We keep joking all these things. They said, oh, that's a damn good melody, yeah. Let's just put it.
That's how the way the song just came into place, man. And with this whole rock guitar thing at the back, the blues rock guitar thing at the back, these are magical moments. This is what we'll never forget, man. Actually, I should write a book with all the magical moments.
One unknown fact about me, I'm writing a book.
You are? Is there enough masala to maybe make a biopic someday on this trio? Because no one's ever thought of a biopic on music directors in India. Is there enough?
Because the thing is, but a lot of people will get insulted.
Why?
If they're to use the real stuff.
We've got enough.
They said, did we actually work with these guys?
We've got enough body of work to make a biopic.
No, we've had a lot of
But
I
if
mean,
there,
funny
if it
incidents.
Does happen in real life, who would play the three of you? If you were to pick one actor to play you.
I like myself.
No, no, if you have to pick an actor. Yeah.
Pick an actor to play.
I wouldn't know. No. I really don't know.
How about you?
I wouldn't mind Ranveer Singh playing me.
Shankar sir?
I don't know, yeah. I really can't think of.
Okay, what would it be called?
Oh.
It couldn't be called Amar Akbar Anthony because that's already been done.
I steered clear of it because I knew that it's been done forever.
Yeah.
Those three guys is nice. Pagal Khana would be another nice one.
Pagal and Khana.
Yeah, Pagal Khana, correct.